Alright, so I am going to say this right here, right now, before we begin anything. I'm first going to have someone made a good suggestion on my poll video, and that would be to disable comments on in the comments section for these videos, because this is gonna be completely blind. Like, pretty much like my Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright, except for that last few videos, because frickin' recording decided to be screwy. But otherwise, that playthrough's pretty blind, and no one made any stupid remarks, but I have in the past with Dual Destinies had remarks with what's gonna happen and stuff, and I'm just going to make it where once this playthrough's done, I will release the comments section. You can say whatever you want. However, if there is a problem or something with the video, please feel free to either message me on YouTube via the going to my channel's main channel page, going to the About section, and then send a message. That's one way to get a hold of me. And then the other, which is a lot easier, is Twitter. Twitter, again, took me like 5 minutes to make an account. And just tweet something at me, and then I will answer that, or I will definitely be informed. And yeah, just the only thing that I do not recommend on Twitter, because I will not answer you if you I will not answer this thing if you make that kind of question, is will you follow me? I don't follow too many people on Twitter just to keep everything straight, because I like getting certain news from certain people and stuff, and yeah, so I don't follow random people on Twitter, even if they are like, I mean, there's some people that I should be following that I haven't followed, so yeah, but either way, comment section gonna be disabled. If you got a remark to say, which I will appreciate, if I don't get any messages or anything on this video via PM, then that means, like, either PM or Twitter, that means the part is okay, there's no sound problems or anything. You should be able to hear background music right now. And yeah, but right now we're gonna do Danganronpa 2. As you can tell, I got Danganronpa 1 right there, but people wanted me to do 2. Heard people keep telling me it's better, and reason why I'm doing this now is because I'm just gonna make a quick video to test some waters with the Vita, because no one wanted to reply on Binding of Isaac, so it's like, well, and not as many people would have watched that either, so it was like, well, since no one's gonna do it, that means no problems with the Vita. So yeah, plus, people said they'd rather see a blind. I will leave a link in the description for someone that you can watch if you want to get filled in on what's happening in Danganronpa 1, because this game takes place right after 2. You need to play 1 or have watched 1 in order to get what's going on. And same thing with Corpse Party. You need to play Corpse Party 1 to pretty much get an idea for Corpse Party Book of Shadows for the most part. So yeah, that's pretty much what I gotta say about that. So same thing with Danganronpa 2. Reason why I'm not showing the box is because this was actually the last copy of the game, and they did that whole spare box thing, so yeah, everyone knows how that works. It kinda sorta ticks me off, since you don't even have a box, so it should be considered used if you don't even have the box anymore. But either way, there's Danganronpa 2. Some people put a space between Dangan and Rompa. Some people don't. So yeah, I'm gonna probably put it as spaced in the title, but actually, before I do that, I like being organized and putting it like right there, so there we go. But yeah, with that, let us get underway. As you can tell, I have not even played this yet on this Vita. I just put it in and downloaded it into the Vita. And let's see what happens. I'm gonna take off my camera and mic while I'm pretty sure cutscene's gonna happen, so. Or not. That is how much I do not know about this game. So, yeah, I've played the first one, and I know this is spoiler territory for the first one now, so I know the whole mastermind was, I forget their names, I'm horrible with names, but it was the girl that got killed at the very beginning, which was actually her sister, that is the best in military and was a mercenary during her youth and yada yada yada. I know everything about Danganronpa 1 because I played it, so yeah, don't worry, I play the first one, even though I don't have the video in the first one in this channel. So let's, oh right, one thing about this, I'm used to Japanese, like this Vita is circled to confirm and X to cancel, so I'm used to pressing circle, so yeah, let's actually press new game. From the beginning, options, is the subtitles on or something? Yeah. Right. I like it fast. Voice volume. Voices, if I remember right, I know voices in Danganronpa 1, they only like play at the beginning of stuff until you get into the trial area, so that's that. You should hear the game quite well. I'm gonna turn it down on my end because I think it's high enough for that. Okay. Alright, so from the beginning. Yes, I want it in Japanese. No. It's easier with English when you're in the trials. Logic. Actually, let's be mean. Mean. Okay.
Hey.
I thought the first game was kind of easy on normal somewhat. So, I mean, it gave you like 20 minutes for the trial part. It's like, what was mean? Apparently, the guy that I linked in the description, he played it on mean, I believe. So, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
You seem pretty out of it.
Is this actually gonna have English voice acting for the entire thing? I don't know.
To be honest, I'm also... No, everyone else feels the same too. Since we suddenly got put in this weird situation. Hey. Are you listening?
Yes, I am. But I'm just gonna dot you off instead. I don't understand. Why am I here? What happened? I should try to remember that first. I began to think, disentangling the twisted knots that had formed in my mind. Think, 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 think! The only thing I remember, I think I remember about this game, is that you play as Makoto's sister, so I might be a girl right now. As I gathered the fragments of my scattered memories, I began to piece together what actually happened. That's right. I... Okay. Danganronpa 2, Goodbye Despair. Start the game. Gotta love that old 8-bit thing. That day, it wasn't just a typical day for me. It was a day that left... That left. That felt truly significant. And when that long-awaited day finally came, I felt proud in a way I can't really put into words. I felt like I had just become part of something greater than myself. Does that make any sense? Actually, that's exactly what it was like. I was truly in a dream. Hope's Peak Academy. That place was so much more than a school to me. Kids who love to play baseball will long to join the major leagues. Kids who love to play soccer will long to join a rep team. And ever since I was a kid, I felt the same way about Hope's Peak Academy. Hope's Peak Academy is a government-funded school for the privileged elite of society. It recruits top students from every imaginable field to inspire hope, and in doing so, shape the future. Whenever Hope's Peak Academy is mentioned, it's only a matter of time before someone says, "If you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life." And just so you know, that's not a joke or an exaggeration at all. Many of the current leaders of various industries are actually alumni of this school. And that's basically what Hope's Peak Academy is all about. As they say, it's truly the Academy of Hope. There are two criteria you must meet in order to attend this school. One, you must be a current high school student, and two, you must be the very best at what you do, like no one ever was. Unlike other schools, there aren't any entrance exams at this academy. The only way to get in is if the school scouts you itself. That is how Hope's Peak Academy operates. Now, because of the talents of those who are chosen, the students of Hope's Peak Academy are called Ultimates. But even though I'm finally going to Hope's Peak Academy, the school I desired more than anything else? The truth is, my circumstance is a little different than that of my peers. Well, I guess I can put that aside for now. You'll find out soon enough, and it's nothing special worth talking about, I think. I know what it is, because I'm pretty sure that's Makoto right there. And the lucky student, which doesn't that sound familiar? You can't spell lucky without... Shut up, Luke. Anyway, I guess I should introduce myself first.
I'm not so special that I have to introduce myself. And formalities are always a little embarrassing. Well, this is what's expected. I guess that's how I should think about it. My name is Hajime Hinata.
Hajime Hinata, okay. Yeah, I don't know what's going on right now. I never seen this character in my life. He just has the same exact haircut as Makoto with the big piece of hair coming out of the top of his head. Just a little different outlook, though. Like, Makoto had a hoodie and stuff.
There's only one reason I came to Hope's Peak Academy. Because I admired Hope's Peak Academy.
Also, the voices have seemed kind of muffled. I made this mention before because some of the volume stuff, the music sounds good, the stupid voices sound weird coming out on my side. At least I don't know about y'all's side, so this is a first video, so again, if there's any problems, PM me or Twitter me.
To me, attending Hope's Peak Academy is like being a celebrity or a superhero. In fact, instead of calling it admiration, it's more like it's always been a dream of mine. That's why, to feel like a member of society, to become someone I can be proud of. I always wanted to...
Until now, I never wanted to admit how painfully ordinary I really am. That's why hope. I might have admired talent individuality, but I have finally forever tried my best. Finally came through. Huh? What is this? It's a door. Why does it remind me of a door that goes into the Velvet Room or something? There's a door. Still, I need to hurry. Because I need to go inside this classroom. Need? What need? No, I should hurry. And here are our special guests for today! Or for this game, I should say.
Huh? Who goes there?
Yes,
Are you feeling all right? You look quite pale. Hey, could you be... You're also a freshman at this school, right?
Then... See for yourself. We're all freshmen too.
These guys? Everyone? The freshmen who were accepted into Hope's Peak Academy? The Ultimates?
I assume. Freshmen like us have been gathered in this classroom.
Gathered?
Hey! Why don't you come inside for now?
You know who you look like? He looked like that... He, like, looked like a fat version of that rich kid, in the first game. With those evil eyes and that blonde hair, you don't look like a handsome person too much like him, but...
Hey! Why don't you just come inside for now?
Yes, of course, yeah. Wait, why am I being so polite? He looks like a jerk. I know they're called the Ultimates, but they're still high school students like me. That's right, first impressions are crucial in moments like this. I need to act more confident. Thus, to hide my nervousness from the others, and while trying my very best to act cool, I stepped inside, closed the door behind me, and sat in an open seat at the back of the classroom. Anyway, what just happened earlier? I wanted to be here, and then a classroom door appeared right in front of me, as if I was drawn to it. But how did I walk into this classroom? I don't remember. Something's... weird. Excuse me?
What is it?
Why are we all gathered in this classroom? No one said anything about coming here, so is there like an entrance ceremony or homeroom happening now?
Actually, we were just about to discuss that matter.
Discuss? You even have the same voice! Come on, it's obvious, but at the same time... You look like you should not have that voice whatsoever.
Well, since you are the last student to arrive, let's start the discussion!
Eh? This is everyone? How do you know?
There are only 16 desks in this classroom, and this guy's the 16th student after all. It's obvious if you bother to think about it.
what is your voice? I don't even know if you... No, you are definitely a girl. I think those are breasts. I don't know, actually. And just what are we gonna talk about? The reason we're all gathered here in this classroom?
First, I need to confirm something. Out of everyone here, is there anyone who actually remembers how they came to this classroom?
Eh? We all looked around at each other. A surprised look appeared on everyone's face. Not one person raised their hand.
I see.
So, before you realized it, you were in this classroom, and then everyone here is in the same predicament.
Very strange.
Yes, very strange. No matter how you look at it, it's unnatural. Even you stupid-looking ones would agree, right? It's very stupid, not like me. I don't look stupid.
What's going on?
It sure is strange. Nobody actually remembers how they came here.
Hey,
what do you mean? Oh. Hey, what do you mean stupid looking? I don't think you look that stupid looking, but still.
So in other words,
the moment you stepped foot on this campus, you felt a strange dizziness, and now you're here, and you don't know why. This is what I experienced before I arrived here. Am I correct in assuming that's true for all of you?
That's happened to me too, but...
Eh? That dizziness wasn't just me? Everyone felt the same dizziness? That's just weird. Even if it's just a coincidence, it feels too good to be true.
Naturally,
of course. So you say it's not just a coincidence, then?
So in other words...
Meaning? We can only speculate who's responsible for this strange phenomenon.
Who's responsible? What is it? It feels like this is going to get even stranger.
Ha! I don't know what you're so worried about, but that doesn't sound like a huge deal to me.
I gave you the other guy voice, but you look like a...
What do you mean?
So what I mean is,
it's a minor problem. Instead of trying to figure out why we're here, we should just try to figure out why we can't leave.
And you look like the gym girl from the first game.
Huh? What do you mean we can't leave? Seriously?
Oh, it is a him! He just has a big... That looks like a curve right there. I only see the upper... You have a weird body proportion, dude.
I watched him rush over to the door and try with all his might to pull it open, but...
It won't open!
I can't open it? Huh? Why?
A little while after I got here, I tried to leave to go take a
Of course he would say that!
Take a crap! Yes, a big crap, because I'm a big tough guy. But that door won't budge at all, and I had to crap in here in the corner.
Hey,
dog, what's going on?
Even with all my might, I couldn't open it. It'd be absolutely impossible for all of you, of course. I mean, look at how big these muscles are.
What? What do you mean you couldn't open it? Why? That's not possible.
She's right. It's impossible. Because when I went through the door, it opened normally. It wasn't locked at all.
Though I don't understand what forces are at work here. There's no denying
that we have been locked inside this classroom. Locked inside? What do you mean, locked inside? I suddenly became aware of how heavy my body felt. As though a feeling of unspeakable dread began settling on my shoulders.
Are we screwed?
Maybe, dog. We're getting mixed up in something dangerous, man.
This is...
Or perhaps, doesn't it make more sense to think that this is the entrance exam? Meanwhile, while my character looks like a young, like, kind of looks like Makoto, but a more grown up one. He looks like an old version of Makoto. The entrance exam? Do you mean Hope Peak's Academy?
However.
But according to Hope's Peak Academy, no such entrance exam exists. They may say that publicly, but it's possible that this is actually a special entrance exam.
That's wrong!
Ah, you're wrong! This is not an entrance exam!
What?
What was that just now?
Hey, bastard!
Hey, fat ass! Why'd you make that cutesy voice all of a sudden?
I won't dispute your blunt remark about my weight. Even if I talk like this, even though this game makes it sound like I don't talk like this, that voice you just heard was not mine.
Huh?
Huh? Then whose was it? It's mine, actually.
Who's there? Where are you? I'm gonna show my power level with my lightning eyebrows.
Perhaps.
It sounds like it came from behind the teacher's desk. Behind the teacher's desk?
Hello?
All right, I see everyone has arrived. Let's begin. Oh no. I think I know what was coming. I preferred Monokuma.
What is that?
Oh my god, it's a stuffed animal!
It looks like a stuffed animal.
Oh, wow, I called that.
That's right! I am a squeezably soft stuffed animal. Magical Miracle Girl Usami, aka Usami.
Oh boy.
I may not look like it, but I am your squeezably soft teacher.
Do you blow up if you get touched, though, or kicked or anything? Because I remember that in the last game, Monokuma did not like getting kicked. Or touched at all, I should say.
Nice to meet you all. Huh?
Huh? Am I hallucinating? Am I the only one who's seeing this?
What's going on?
Nah, man, I see it too! What's with this talking chihuahua? What? Chihuahua? Eh? That's a chihuahua?
Everyone!
Does everybody here know what a rabbit is? I do. Apparently no one else does. They confuse it with a freaking chihuahua somehow. It's a lovable animal that's very fluffy and soft. That's what I am, a singing, dancing, talking rabbit mascot! Hold on! Let me process this first! Okie dokie! I have always spelled okie dokie like that! Wait, I'm pretty sure. Yeah! Like that. Yet every time I see Okie Dokie, it's spelled O-K-E-Y-D-O-K-E-Y. So, just like G's. Jesus spelt G-E-E-Z and J-E-E-Z, but I usually see with a G more. But that's the first time I've ever seen it spelt like that. Besides from me. What do you guys think? I've never seen a stuffed animal that can sing, dance, and talk before. I've seen one that can talk. Kinda sing. It's probably remote controlled or something. Wait. I should give you the stuck up voice. It's probably remote controlled or something. Don't act like such a pussy over a child's toy. Even if it's a remote control, dude, doesn't it look too lifelike? That's pretty advanced for a toy, dog.
His movements and mannerisms are not the issue. More importantly, based on what it just said, it seems like you know something about our current situation.
Leave it to me.
Of course I do. I'm the lead teacher of this school trip.
School trip?
Come on.
Hey, what do you mean school trip?
A large group of students go on a chaperone trip with the lead teacher. It's the biggest event of the school year. We're not looking for such a literal answer, actually. Now let's depart for the fun school trip. Depart? Wait, what's happening? Couldn't believe my eyes! Not just my eyes, but my brain, too. The world just stopped making sense. The classroom collapsed like a stage set, and what appeared before me instead was blue sky, white clouds like Hawaii, blue seas and white waves. What the hell is this? No matter how I tried to rationalize it, it was abnormal. Clearly unreasonable. Utterly crazy! Blatantly wrong. What?
Are you kidding me?
This is a joke. Right, dog? Right? Where are we?
Why?
Huh? What's going on?
Everyone,
please calm down. There is no reason to panic. See? Look around. Feast your eyes on this beautiful ocean. It's like your heart is being washed clean, isn't it? It washes away everything, even all the bad things.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Give us the details. Where in the world are we?
Where, you ask? Well, obviously we're in
Hawaii?
Out where it's better! Out where it's redder! Out by the sea!
Where's the poo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoos?
Oh, I understand the sea, but what are we doing here? You know, your throat's gonna get hoarse if you keep screaming like that and talking like a girl, Luke.
Shut up, game!
Something like this. But we were just at school, and now we are by the sea. This is impossible.
No problem.
Please do not worry. The school trip has just started. That's all.
Hold on a sec.
But, like,
Why are we on a school trip all of a sudden? You totally skipped all the stuff that comes first. I mean, after all, this is the first day. Who's heard of a first day field trip? She's right, actually. We're all supposed to be attending Hope's Peak Academy. Hope's Peak Academy. I see. You don't say. You guys are feeling unsure about Hope's Peak Academy. Then in that case, please forget about Hope's Peak Academy. That's why we're having a school trip in the first place.
The hell do you mean we should forget about it? Hey, what are you? Just, what are you scheming?
What? I'm not scheming anything. I'm doing this for everyone's sake. I'm praying from the bottom of my heart that hope will grow within everyone's heart.
What?
I guess that's why it's called Goodbye Despair, but at the same time, aren't we a little too ahead of the game right now? Shouldn't you be scheming for despair? Or is that just Monokuma's thing?
No,
there's nothing dangerous on this island whatsoever, so please, there is no need to worry at all. Island? Did you just say island?
Yep, it certainly is beautiful. It was prepared just for us, an island free from other people in danger.
I notice you have a video camera over there. Are you filming this for worldwide showings?
I didn't want to press that. I didn't even read that.
Perhaps you brought us to this uninhabited island to make us kill each other?
Nah, that's too simple.
Get killed each other? Nuh-uh, no way. Bloody business like causing violence or inflicting pain is a big no-no on this island. That's only for the Monokuma's little show he has going across the globe right now. Even the word kill, just saying it horrifies me. Yeah, it's so scary.
Lin, what is this school trip you mentioned? What do you intend for us to do on this island?
Alrighty, I shall announce it to everyone right now. While you all relax on this island paradise, you must get along and strengthen your bonds with one another. This is the main rule on this heart-throbbing school trip.
What did you say?
Heart-throbbing school trip? I hate heart-throbbing school trips.
That's right.
Spend these peaceful and relaxing days nourishing hope and lazing about, free from pain, free from suffering. Truly, this lovey-dovey heart-throbbing school trip is everyone's homework.
Hey, what?
What the hell does that even mean? Now then,
let the heart-throbbing school trip begin.
Well, at least I get familiar music. It goes without saying, but I had no idea what she was talking about. I couldn't follow her words at all. And then just like that, like a curtain slowly lowering, my mind ground to a halt. Never mind. Soda? Heard of SOTA, but not soda. I can't read all the names. They're sideways or vertical. I recognize that name. I saw it. Togami. It is freaking Togami. I recognize that freaking name. Holy crap. I'm gonna stop the video here at saving the progress, actually. Yes. Yeah, I'm gonna save it here. As you can tell, it's 5:03 in the friggin' morning. And actually, I'm going to leave the comments on for this first video only, just to make it easier, because I want to hear feedback. But if you spoil anything whatsoever, consider the comment blocked, and I really don't want to ban anyone, but I will. I really don't want to ban anyone or block people for the channel, but please do not freaking spoil it on this first video. If you spoil anything, you will very, let's just put it kind of bluntly and say you'll piss me off. Yeah. Yeah. So with that, that is Danganronpa 2 Goodbye Despair, the first part. Again, let me know how it sounds on your side, and if I need to try to make adjustments on the volume. Because at the same time, if you look, let me see if I can drag this. No, I cannot. But pretty much, out of 10 bars, the volume is at 3 right now on the recording device, because that's as max as it can go. And also, let me see. It's also at max on here, as you can tell. And if it was not, if this was not if the mic was not boosted at 20 right now, it would be sounding very, very crappy, because, well, you would barely be able to hear it, because that's what it sounds like without the mic boost. That's what it sounds like with the mic boost. So yeah, that's what I gotta deal with. That's why I would like some opinions on the volume and stuffs, and voice act, like the voices in the game and stuff. I might need the voices on during the class trial portion, but otherwise, voices can be off for the most part throughout the investigation mode, as the game called it at the beginning before I started the game. So, yeah, again, hope you all enjoyed, and I will be leaving comments on this first video only, but after this, comments will be off, and the reason why I recorded this before New Year's Day, or put it up before New Year's Day and recorded it before New Year's Eve, is because there was nothing else to record. I didn't want to set up the capture card for consoles or anything, and have not played. I did not want to grind on Fantasy Life at 4 o'clock in the morning right now. And this was the only thing that sounded interesting to play, since I beat Phoenix Wright earlier tonight. So yeah. So yeah, yeah. With that, hope you all enjoyed, and I will catch you all next time. Have a great day.